Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. This pattern right here is going to be my next Luderlo sew along. And so let's take a look at it. It's a hoodie and it's color blocked. But I think already my plan, it's going to be this main area of blue. I'm going to have blue sleeves and this top part and this bottom part will be pink. And then the cowl neck will be blue because I think that's the fabric that I have to work with, and I think that will be enough fabric that I have. I'm going to leave out these purple sections. As we could see down here, there's a purple section. I'm leaving those purple sections out, and I also think looking at the pattern, it doesn't really show the purple section. It doesn't really show the pattern piece. So this is our pattern right here, number 50, and this came with the kit. So when I purchased the kit, I got the binder with 200 and something patterns, and this was part of the kit. So I'm going to put it down on the table so that we could see it a little bit better. Okay. So with this pattern, we have A, this is our front piece. We have B, our back piece. We have E, our sleeve, and this squiggly line here is for gathers. EF times two is your sleeve cuff. So as we could tell by in the picture, there's a cuff on the sleeve there. And it's a 3/4 length sleeve. It's not a full sleeve. All right, we have our cowl neck here, and then this is our drawstring for that cowl neck. Looking at these pictures, we could tell that the solid lines are our cutting lines, and this BM is center front and this HM is center back, and that means those two are cut on the fold because they're not depicted by a solid line, so that means it's on the fold. So this is our cowl neck, we'll fold it in half. There's top stitching along the cowl neck there. The cuff also folded in half. And now let's look at our sewing sequence. So this little half circle there, or triangle, indicates that that is cut at a right angle, so 90 degrees. And so they should all line up nice. So they have A and A, so we're attaching the top section together, then you're attaching the bottom section, B. And then C has you attaching your back section together, and then D, your back bottom section. And that's about it. Then it has F and F, so you're attaching the cuff to the sleeve. And that's about all that we have giving us information in order to sew. So what I think I would do is I would follow this order, sew up these two sections, these two, then these two, then these two. Next, I would sew my shoulder seams, and then I could attach my sleeve in the flat because this is a knit pattern. So I would attach my sleeve in flat, and then I would sew the side seam of the sleeve along with the side seam of the top in one go. And then I would probably attach the cowl neck, and then I would attach the cuff to the sleeve. And I think that's all. I think this is going to be a good sew. I think it's going to be easy. I recommend, if you're unsure about Luderlo like I am, I would start off with simple sews. And this, it looks fairly straightforward. Sorry, there's a glare there. It looks straightforward, and I think it's going to be a good pattern. So if you want to come and join me in sewing this one, I recommend that you do get your fabric ready. I am using fabric that I got from my Think Pink subscription sew box. It's blue and pink, and you'll see that in the next episode. But other than that, I'm not going to make any changes to this one as I did my previous one. Also, if you want to see my previous sew along, I'll leave links below. I made that dress with the waist with the elastic waist, but this one I'm going to keep it as is. The only difference is I'm not adding in these purple sections. And as you could tell, there is not much to show you for the purple section. In fact, it's a cutting line and that's a top stitch. So it doesn't really have a piece for the purple, but they've added it in. And it sometimes makes me wonder about Letterlow if they actually make all of these patterns that they come out with. I know every season they come out with about maybe 50 to 40 patterns. And I'm curious to know if they've made up these or if they're just programming it into their software and then spitting out an image. So I wonder if they sew up every single pattern, because sometimes their instructions or the pieces don't make sense. But that's what I'm sewing with, so I hope that you'll come and join me, and I will see you all next time.